Like the alphabet, or is there more?
Can I ask one last question? I don't know if, you know, like where we have the J and then N. You ever see that before?
Oh, yeah.
What is
So
that all
in
about?
Pali, that never happens.
Okay.
So, for example,
That'll be
in
fun.
Sanskrit, you get prajna.
Right.
In Pali, you would see panya. Where you see a J and an Enye in conjunction in Pali, it's always in the other order. Oops. Like, it would always be like that.
Okay.
Like,
And so how do you pronounce that?
Like an Enye and then a J.
Nyeji?
Like Sanjanati is one that comes to mind.
So it's not really a true Enya at that point, then, though.
So Sanjanati, yeah, it just sounds like an N now that I think
Yeah.
about it. Sanjanati. But it's important to know because that is what will always appear before a J or a C.
Okay.
Or like Sanchetana. It'll always be the Enye before a C or a J.
Really interesting, okay.
This is another thing about the Pali alphabet. So you'll notice how each one of these rows is four similar consonants followed by one nasal consonant. So any time a nasal consonant is conjoined with a consonant, another consonant, it will always be from the same row.
Oh, cool.
So this will always be followed by one of these. This will always be followed by one of these, and so on, with very few exceptions.
Oh,
So we'll.
cause you can go like in the back of the throat, or in the middle, or in the front. So it's actually like, so they're making a distinction between those different sounds based on where the tongue is pressing.
Right.
I
So
see.
it's all about what's easiest to pronounce.
Cool.
So Pali will morph letters in order to make things easier to say. As opposed to Sanskrit, which is quite happy to preserve awkward consonant combinations.
When there are two J's or two K's, does that affect the pronunciation?
Double consonants are always pronounced separately.
Okay.
Akka, for example, you would always pronounce it as akka. So you would pronounce both consonants completely and separately.
So it's like the same in Italian, right? Where you like close it and then like versus just like keep going through it.
Yeah.
Acca instead of
The only exception I can think of is like with Dhamma. So you don't say Dhamma, it's
Acca. Okay.
Dhamma. So in that case, you're just extending the amount of time.
Right, like
Because that's a different
Dhamma.
word than Dhamma. Dhamma is a different word. So we have to be able to clearly distinguish between those two or things get
Dhamma,
mixed up.
Dhamma.
Yeah.
Okay.
What does that mean, Dhamma?
I don't
Yeah,
remember off the top of my head.
comma versus comma. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Dhamma, action. Kama,
Yeah.
sensuality. Totally different words, not to be confused. Okay, anything else on alphabet or pronunciation?
We didn't even do pronunciation.
Well, do we want to do pronunciation?
Yeah.
I'm not particularly interested. I mean, we're kind of touching on it all along anyway.
Yeah, completely cool. No, I'm just.
Okay, so that's not. Moving on to the subject at hand. So first, covering a brief review of the material from chapters 8 and 9, and then we'll cover the new material from chapter 10. So first off, the vocative case. So we previously covered the first seven declensions, the first seven cases of nouns. So the vocative case is the final one. So at this point, we have all of them. The vocative case in the singular form usually is simply the stem form of the word. So Buddha here is the recognizable stem form of the word. And the plural simply elongates the final vowel. So Buddha, Buddha. And the vocative form is used when speaking directly to someone. So in saying like, hey Sarah, or hey John, or hey Sally, or whoever, you're speaking directly to them. So that's when the vocative is used. It's in direct speech. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Any questions on vocative? All right. Also introduced in, I believe, chapter 8 was neuter nouns. So these are still neuter nouns ending in A. So that's all we've been handling so far is nouns ending in A. Neuter nouns, it gives several examples in the text. They're declined quite similarly to masculine nouns ending in A with these notable distinctions. So first noting that the nominative singular is identical to the accusative singular. So you just need to be attentive to context. And this distinctive ending, ani, this is very unique to the neuter nouns. So rupani can be nominative, accusative, or vocative, plural, for a neuter noun. And also noting rupe, so rupe can be the accusative plural of a nominative noun as well. Accusative plural of a neuter noun as well. Okay, on board? Any questions?
So aside from the nominative, accusative, and vocative, are they pretty much all the same?
The rest are the same as masculine nouns ending in A. So it's all the same as what we've already covered.
So, like mangarani, that's...
That is a neuter noun.
So mangarani would be the nominative.
Yeah.
Singular.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah. I have a question about one of the sentences from lesson 8.
Let's go through the material here first, and then we'll talk about the specific examples.
Okay.
So then the gerund or the absolutive, which I believe was chapter 9. So the gerund or absolutive indicates the preceding action. It's what happened immediately prior to the present action. So you can translate it as having done or after doing. So in this example here, bhattang yachitva yachiko bhunjati. So after begging for food, the beggar eats. Or having begged for food, the beggar eats. You can take it either way. So it really depends upon how you want to handle it. But that's the sense of it. It's the preceding action.
So there's no gerund in the sense of like modern European languages, then like gerund would be like being, doing, you know, eating.
No, that in Pali we would call that a present participle.
Okay.
And so like the ing verbs, that's a present participle and it's handled like a noun.
Right.
And we'll deal with that later on.
Yeah, that threw me for a loop because that.
So maybe go with absolutive then.
Okay.
I've always referred to it as the absolutive, but I think in this book it referred to it as a gerund, which I thought was a bit strange.
I think you're right.
Page 12. This. Oh, that's why I look weird. Yeah, gerund, absolutive, or indeclinable.
I'll take indeclinable participle.
Well, indeclinable, though, is there's a whole category of words that are indeclinable. So this is just one example of
indeclinable.
Yeah, absolutive. I just call it absolutive.
Absolutely.
So the standard ending for this...
Sorry.
The standard ending is twa. Which sometimes uses a linking vowel of I, so twa or itva, or occasionally just ya is the suffix. And when the suffix is just ya, there's a couple forms which we'll sometimes see. So if ya is immediately following a consonant, then that sometimes the y will be assimilated to that consonant.
That's great.
Not really at all. So agamya becomes agamma.
Is it possible to be more precise about often? Like in what cases does it and in what cases does it not?
Okay, so generally speaking, Pali does not permit most adjacent consonants to be different from each other. So permissible adjacent consonants are things like that. Or as we mentioned before, yeah, or like NK, that'd be permissible. There's
or
a handful,
H.
What's that?
Or like something H.
Yeah.
Like PH.
Yeah.
Or the, that's one letter, but.
Yeah, though again, the PH here is a single letter. But it's similar enough to the previous one that it's permissible. But agamya is not permissible because they're too different. And in some cases, so generally speaking, dissimilar consonants will be made similar. Generally speaking.
What if there's the preceding consonant is an N? Would it become like N tilde, or would the Y drop?
Yeah, if we'll get into all this later because there's a whole world of rules specifically about this. But briefly, yes. So NY would generally become that.
Oh, a double N.
Yeah.
Oh.
So if, and I'm just making up a word here because I can't think of a specific example. If the root was agun instead of agum, so agunya would become a. Aganya.
Cool, thank you.
Okay, and the other case is if a Y is follows an H, then they'll switch places. Which, again, is a little bit mind-blowing, but it makes it easier to pronounce. And it's all about what makes things easier to pronounce.
So, like, can you pronounce that for me?
Oruyaha.
Oruyaha?
Yeah. Still awkward, I'll admit.
Kind of, yeah.
But try to say it the other way. Oruhaya. You wind up adding.
Got it.
Okay, you win. You win. So, are we okay in the absolutive? Any questions on that? Assimilation and transposition sound complicated, but when you see them in context, it quickly becomes apparent that it's really not that weird or far out. It's quite easy to handle. It's also not, in the context of absolutive, it's not that common. Most common is twa, and ya, you'll see less commonly, but still enough to recognize it. These incidents of assimilating the ya, not so common. And the transposition is so immediately recognizable on account of its weirdness that you'll know right away what's going on.
Right.
Okay. Any questions on absolutive? Okay. Then we have the infinitive, which I think was chapter 10, so this is a new material.
Did you want to? You had a question on chapter 8.
Well, let's go through the cases first, and then we'll handle specific incidents. Okay. So infinitive, this was introduced in chapter 10.
Mm-hmm.
This is another verb suffix. So just as the absolutive is a verb suffix, the infinitive also is a verb suffix, an indeclinable verb suffix. And there's other infinitive forms which we'll learn later, but these are the basic ones that we'll learn for now. So, tong and itong. So, the infinitive form of a verb is to do. It's the to form of the verb. So, for example, daruko ka ditong itchati. The boy wishes to eat, quite literally. Or panhang puchitong gachati. One goes to ask a question. So, it's quite literally to eat or to ask. So, very simple.
And this can never be used as nouns.
No.
It wouldn't be like eating or asking.
No. So that's the, again, that's the present participle, which we will get to because it's a very common form that's used in Pali.
Okay.
And once you recognize the present participle, you'll find that there's a lot of words that you thought were nouns, but are actually present participles. Actually, dana. Dana is a present participle.
Really?
Yeah. And again, I don't want to get too ahead of things, but I just love present participles, so I have to talk about that. Da plus ana. The ana suffix is ing. It's a present participle suffix.
Yeah, yeah.
So, dana. Dana literally means giving.
So that's what I would call the gerund, by the way, one thing.
Okay. I stand corrected. I've learned something new about grammatical terms. Again, I only know grammatical terms in the context of Pali. I don't know them in the context of anything else. Anyway, so that's a present participle.
That's cool.
We'll learn more about such things at a later time. And you had some specific... I have some sentences I wanted to go through at some point, but first we can handle the question you had.
Okay.
Where is it?
It's lesson 8. Number 14.
14, okay.
Yeah.
Let's pull this one out. Alright, so... do we want to go ahead and walk through this? Or do you just want to ask your question directly?
So I first translated it as the boy takes a flower to the uncle from the park, but couldn't it also be the boy takes the uncle's flower from the park?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
The one thing you're missing is that flower is...
Plural. Okay.
Yeah. So flowers.
Okay.
Yeah, it could be either the boy takes flowers from the park for the uncle,
mm-hmm.
or the boy takes the uncle's flowers from the park. Either one is technically correct.
Okay.
Good times.
Yeah.
Joy rising. Yeah. Having joy rising.
Yeah.
Still not there.
So.
Thank you.
All right. Any other questions before we start looking at some other sentences?
Lesson 9, number 3.
Dharaka Pupani Sangharatva Matulasadatva Hasanti, this one?
Yes.
Okay, let's pull that one out and see what we're looking at. Okay. So?
I think the dhatva was... So it's like, that's having given.
Correct.
Okay.
This is... One of the few things I dislike about the Pali Primer is that some of the sentences are just so ridiculous. And this is one example. It's just like...
So I have that... I have a couple of possible translations. Maybe they're both possible. And I was confused because the meaning is kind of weird.
Let's go ahead and just work through the sentence and
okay.
pull out the different words, and then we'll talk about the different possible meanings. So first off, dharaka.
For children.
Children? Okay. Okay.
Or from a child.
Could be, correct. But let's go with children for now. Pupani. Yep. Sangharitva. Having gathered. Okay.
These flowers, can we tell whether the flowers is nominative or accusative at this point?
We can't, but realistically, we can assume accusative since it's coming right before the absolutive. Matulasa.
To the uncle.
Okay. Dattva. Okay. And Hasanti.
Left.
laugh.
And it is... What case?
They. It's a plural.
Okay. So what are we looking at here then? Let's put this all together. Okay, so you jump directly to the laughing part.
Yeah.
That's good. So usually when a sentence contains absolutive phrases, you want to start with the absolutive phrases and then move on to the subject and the verb and any other objects or other words in the sentence.
So
I would start with Pupani Sangharitva, so having gathered flowers, Tatra Matulasa, and having given them probably to the uncle, the children laugh. That's most likely what this sentence is saying.
It's nonsensical, but it is.
Exactly. This is what I said.
Yeah,
Polly Primer has some really nonsensical sentences. I mean, this is a plausible scenario. It's just...
It's why, I don't know.
Yeah.
Something that feels like random about it.
Anyway.
Kids are weird, though. They laugh at everything.
It's true.
Exactly.
It's true.
You just can't take offense at it.
No.
Okay, so are we clear on that one? Any other particular sentences to bring up, or shall we work on translating some things? All right. So let's look at some of the sentences that I pulled out here. So first off, Ludakasa putto megasa kayang hatena pusati. Thoughts? Let's start working through this word by word. Ludakasa.
Thief. No, that's
Cora. Hunter. Yeah, Ludaka is hunter, and what's the declension?
Of her four,
correct. Okay, and putto.
Son.
Good. Megasa means what? What is a mega?
Deer.
Megasa then is?
Deer.
And singular or plural?
Singular.
Good. Kayang.
Pani. Accusative,
yep.
Singular.
Yep. And hatena.
Instrument. And singular.
Okay. And pusati.
Pusati.
PJ? touching.
Touch, yeah.
I'm not sure what's going on there.
Oh,
okay.
You just got a like on Facebook Live for that.
Cool.
I'll go avante.
I'll take all the likes I can get.
Is that what I did for pasta or no?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, good call. That is related to pasta. Pasta means... contact,
right.
Literally touching, or touch. Correct. Same root as pusati. So, taking this sentence then, somebody want to take a stab at it? What's going on here?
The hunter's son touches the deer's body with his hand.
Correct.
Very good.
Excellent. Wonderful.
Thanks, Nidja.
You get a gold star. So, Dharako Ava Tamhi Patitva Rodati.
Child,
yes.
On the pit, on or near the pit? In the pit?
Probably in the pit. It's hard to be on the pit.
Unless you can flow, yeah.
In the pit.
Good.
Having fallen,
yeah.
Laughs.
Cries.
Sorry, other one. Somebody else laughs. I think he's laughing.
Okay. So a nice simple one. So what's this saying?
Having fallen in the pit, the child cries.
Excellent.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well,
you think that,
well,
what?
Yeah.
That's so twisted.
Good translation.
And now you're justifying.
I know.
Okay, so pandito asanam ha uttehit dva tapasena sadhing bhasadi.
So pandito is the wise man.
Okay.
Namda
singular.
Oh.
Okay, yeah, namda singular.
Seat
yeah.
on.
Seat
or in.
Not
or
on.
At.
Or.
Or, no, for. No.
Wrong.
From.
Yes.
From, yes.
From what?
From or based on the seat.
From the seat.
Chair.
Correct. Asana is another present participle, by the way.
No.
Yeah, I couldn't
yes.
find it.
It's not a... See?
Asana.
Literally means sitting.
But it's a declinable participle. Unlike the indeclinable absolute. Participle.
Present participles are declinable.
See,
declined as nouns.
I'm very happy to know that.
again, once you know how to recognize a present participle, you'll see them everywhere in the Pali language. They're all over the place, lurking.
Waiting for you.
So, asanamha from seat uttehitva. What's going on here?
Having
what? Literally having stood up. And we'll go into prefixes later, but I'm going to point this prefix out anyway. So the prefix ud means up, and ta means stand.
Just because it comes from sta, right? In Sanskrit. Same thing
in Thai. Yeah. So then putting them together, we get Utta means stand up. So having stood up, Tapasena.
With something.
With, correct. You recognize the instrumental case.
Mm-hmm.
So what's a tapasa?
Tapasa is
it's
like a sadhu, somebody who does
austerities. Yep, an ascetic. Ascetic. Sadhing
with
yeah
speaks
correct. So what do we have here?
Having stood up from his seat, the wise man speaks with the ascetic.
Okay, nice and easy. Great. All right. What's up here? What's a Tathagata?
What is a Tathagata?
It's what we're all trying to become.
Exactly. I would just need to.
We can. I've talked before about what a tathagata is.
Yeah.
What that word means. How about pasitva?
Having seen.
Having seen. That's correct.
Seen.
Vanditum.
Worship. Having
worship.
To worship. Correct. Having worship. After worship.
Will.
That's a lot of anxiety.
Yeah, tung is the, or itung is the infinitive ending. So, to worship.
Upasako.
Upasako, what's an upasako?
It's an upasaka.
Disciple or devotee. Raharang. Monastery. Pavisati. Enters, correct. Good one. So, what do we have here?
The disciple having seen the Agatha.
Good.
And there's some we have, the monastery.
Yes, keep going.
In order to worship. Oh.
Yeah. Yep.
Where's the in order to?
It would just be implied. You would just say to worship would
okay.
be a direct translation. He enters the monastery to worship.
Okay.
Now, an interesting thing here, which I don't think has been discussed in the text so far, occasionally in Pali, there will be a single accusative, which is... addressed by multiple verbs.
Mm.
So this may be a case of that. Having seen the Tathagata, the Upasaka enters the monastery to worship the Tathagata. This may be a case of that. You see it more commonly in verse or in poetry rather than in prose, but you do sometimes see it in prose. Okay, let's have a look at another one. What's going on here? Palani.
The fruits.
What is that?
The fruits.
Fruits, okay. So what's the declension here?
It's could be any of the three because it's neuter.
Yeah.
Plural.
Right. So what three could it be?
Accusative, nominative,
it is theoretically possible.
Fruits. Yeah. Hey, fruit, yeah. Hey, fruits. Yeah, there you go.
Did you
call
someone
hey fruits? Oh, you could.
It
you
could
guys
be happening.
For studying college. Hey fruits.
Okay.
So we'll leave that in there as a possibility.
Is that a pure game of
polytheism?
To eat, correct?
The monkeys.
Monkeys. Rukhesu.
In the tree.
In trees, esu, keep in mind, plural.
Yeah. Wandering.
Charanti, yeah, wandering or moving.
So I don't think your hay fruits vocative works.
It seems unlikely.
Yeah, it does.
It seems a bit unlikely. Another reason for that is because speech in Pali usually has an end quote,
mm-hmm.
which we'll handle later, but usually the end quote is ti.
Oh, yeah.
So that would indicate that Palani was a verbal statement.
So the Bhutto Bhagavati, like that's...
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That indicates a quotation.
I didn't realize
it's
that.
Like we're quoting
okay.
the suttas when we say that.
Cool.
So what is this sentence saying?
The
someone
monkeys moving or wandering in the trees... To eat fruit.
All right, there we go.
So,
actually, it shouldn't be moving or wandering. That's moves, wanders, present tense. Present tense, not
present tense.
Wander
is indicative. Happy
wanders are plural.
Plural.
English.
Messed up.
English. Well done.
That's these plural. Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly.
So it gets everybody. The singular third person.
Okay, so now something you're actually likely to see in the suttas somewhere.
Yeah.
Sugatasa savako vaha rasadvarang vivariti.
So the sugat, the happy one, right? So of or the happy one?
Of for sugata, I'm going to leave it untranslated.
Okay. Savako.
What's a savako? Latin? Latin. Disciple, excellent. Viharasa, someone other than Michael.
Of or for the monastery.
Good. Dvarang. Anyone can answer this.
Door.
Door, correct. Vivarati.
Is it like Viveka? Open.
So what do we have here?
We've got a little key, that's what we've got.
In the sentence, what do we have here?
The disciple opens the monastery door for the sugata.
I think that's pretty awesome.
That is one way of translating it, actually. Yeah. Unlikely, though. More likely is it's the disciple of the sugata opens the door of the monastery.
Why?
But yeah, in this case, it's word placement.
Mm.
If it was opens the door for the sugata, we would expect to see sugata over here somewhere. The disciple opens the door of the vihara. Well, no. Even then, where would we put it? We'd also expect... Actually, where would we see it? Anyway.
Maybe at the end?
No, because
the
verb makes sense. Anyway, suffice to say that could possibly be the meaning, but I wouldn't count on it.
Technically correct.
Yes.
Yeah.
You
take your technicalities.
You get extra points. Yeah, no problem. Alright. Stars and extra points.
How about this one?
Disciples.
Disciples.
Samanana.
Samanana. What's going on here? Contemplatives. What about them? No. Not accusative. Samana anang. What's the anang suffix? Look up your charts if you have to.
I am. The plural of the dative or genitive.
Correct. So
nice.
What does that mean?
For or of.
Yeah.
Great.
That's accusative.
Danang is what?
Accusative singular.
Of?
Charity.
Giving.
Okay, let's just call it gift. What's datung?
To give.
To give, excellent. Again, the shared root should be completely obvious here.
Mm-hmm.
Viharang.
Accusative singular.
Of?
Vihara.
Yeah. Pavasanti.
Enter.
Yep. So this should be fairly straightforward. What's this say?
Disciples.
Disciples.
Enter the monastery to give gifts to the
samana.
Yeah. Yep.
To give a gift.
To give a gift. Though dana is a example of something.
Mass noun.
Yeah, mass noun.
Yeah. Honey. You
yeah.
Give honeys. You give just honey.
Yeah. Okay, great. All is well so far.
Question.
Yes.
Why is Samana the second? Why is it the second person
not
in the
sentence? Usually the. Again, you almost read Pali sentences from the backward to the front sometimes. Like from the end to the beginning when you're saying it in English. So it's like the disciples enter the monastery to give dana to the contemplatives. So it's again, it's like you're reading it from the end of the sentence to the beginning.
Okay. Except for that first.
Is there a question from Facebook?
No, just a statement.
A statement?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Practice more. It's advice.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Well, I'm always grateful for advice. So that's why it's located where it is. Does that make sense?
Yeah, so it's like the first possible.
Yeah, the subject of the sentence is usually towards the beginning. Not always, but usually.
So it's subject habit for...
Yeah. Again, often you start by reading the subject, and then you go all the way to the end of the sentence and start reading in backwards order.
If you want to read it as if it were English.
If you wanted to read it as though it was English. Eventually you just get used to reading Pali sentences
yeah,
as Pali.
As Pali.
And then it just becomes totally normal. It's like, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's like the disciples for the contemplatives, dana, to give the monastery enter. It's like, of course, why would you not say that? Okay, next sentence.
I got it.
Alright, give it to me.
Having
no.
Sat on the seat, the monk washes his feet.
Yep. Yeah, we actually don't know they're his feet. We just know that he washes his feet. Yeah, could be somebody else's feet.
Is there a reflexive that we could use to make it his feet?
Yes.
Awesome.
But it is not yet in this book.
Okay.
So you could washing somebody else's feet over here.
It could be happening. All we know is that there's some feet and he's washing them.
Is there a word for chair or is it all sitting?
There is a word that specifically means chair, but it's not used terribly often. Yeah, I mean, I guess chairs weren't used terribly often then, maybe? I don't know.
So this could be like having taken a seat, like we are, like sit
yeah.
in position, more than a chair.
Well, it's having sat on a seat, so it indicates a place where you're sitting.
Mm-hmm.
So a designated sitting spot.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sitting spot.
So.
It's not a chair. It's
a sitting spot.
That works. Okay. Yeah, yeah. No, it works.
Okay. Any questions? Anybody else have any questions on that one? Nice, simple one. Okay. Next one, another nice simple one. Rakamha panani patanti.
From the tree.
From the tree. Panani.
The leaves.
Leaves, good.
Patanti.
Okay. Do I even need to ask what this means?
Please put that as
not. Okay.
We're learning Pali.
Yeah.
You are.
Awesome.
I'm very
amazing.
Impressed. So, what do we have here?
Nara.
Nara is what? Not
men.
A place in Japan.
Men.
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 Plural.
Men.
Yeah, plural. Men.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you said man. Okay.
No,
men.
No. Men. Yeah, I was like, what are you talking about?
He's like, hey, man, what are you talking about?
Thought it was the vocative.
Yeah,
man.
Vocative would be Nara.
No. You thought that his English word was the vocative. Talking
yeah.
to you, man.
Oh.
Man.
Okay, so men, gamamha.
From the village.
From the village,
yeah.
Correct. Nik hametva.
Having gone out.
Yeah, having gone out, or literally walked out. Nagare.
Isn't that city? No, that's Nagare.
Could be city, yeah, yeah. What's going on at the city? What's the declension here for a city?
Isn't it plural? No.
It could actually be many things. So let's start listing out some possibilities.
Accusative plural?
It could be accusative plural. What else could it be?
Locative.
Mm.
Yeah, I would guess it's probably locative.
So in the city.
Vasito.
Something with
vasita. The verb here is vasati, not that that's likely to help.
No.
Dwells.
Yes.
To dwell.
To live or to dwell. Ichanti.
So the same as vihara?
No. I don't think so, no.
Wishes?
Yes.
Or they wish.
They wish, correct. Okay, so what does this say?
Having walked from the village,
yeah,
the
so nikamitva in this case, we can, and so literally it means walked out, but left or departed would probably be closer to the meaning in this sentence. So having left the village, they wish to live in the city. All good on that one? Great. More fun times ahead. Brahmanasagehe asane sinisi ditong rajakasaputta ichanti. Yes, your
question on the previous one?
Okay.
Because we haven't learned the past tense yet, but having done a thing sort of is past tense,
mm-hmm.
Would it be proper or improper to translate that sentence as wishing to live in the city, the men departed the village?
No.
That would not be correct?
No.
Okay.
Because you're using a present participle.
Present participle.
We have not yet learned present participle. We'll get there.
That be ichanna? Oh, ichanna, yes, that makes sense.
Like
that?
Ichana? I mean, that's theoretically possible, but I don't think I've ever actually seen that particular participle. You'll see. There's other words that are used instead. So, Brahmanasagehi asanesu nisidatong rajakasa putta ichanti.
Okay. So,
for
the Brahmana, or the Brahman.
Yeah.
Homes?
What's going on here? Gehi?
Oh, loping. In the home?
Could be in the home. Is there anything else it could be?
Could it be plural? Homes?
Could be. Most likely it's in the house, so let's try that for now, and if that seems weird, then we'll explore the other options.
On the same spots.
In the
seat. On seats, nasi detung.
To sit.
Great. Specifically to sit down.
Is that the knee?
Yeah, knee means down.
So up or for the king?
No. King is Raja, which we'll handle later because it looks like a noun that ends in A, but it's not. It's actually a noun that ends in N.
Nice.
Which is declined very differently.
Okay.
Of or for the washerman.
Yeah.
And the sons.
Sons. Yeah.
Sons. Putta is also sometimes used in a generic sense to mean children.
Okay.
Yeah.
Children.
Offspring.
Yep. Offspring. Okay.
Yeah.
Offspring.
Right.
Yeah.
No, it's good.
So the offspring wish for nirvana. Okay. I'm glad somebody laughed at that. So what's going on here? Yes, correct.
Nice.
So the washer's offspring wish to sit on seats in the house of the Brahman. Again, it's like we're reading it back to front.
All right. Yeah.
That was rough.
That was rough for me.
That was
rough
personal.
Great. I'm glad you're willing to admit when the going is rough. Okay, more fun times. Retain.
Okay. Or a chariot.
Via chariot. Okay, Nagarang.
See the city.
City or town.
Mm-hmm.
To go.
Correct. Puruso.
Man.
Somebody other than Michael.
Sorry.
Is that like person?
What?
Puruso.
Puruso, yeah. Person? Person or man? Yeah. We can leave it as man for now, that's fine. Okay, so somebody other than Michael, Gehasma. House or home? And what's the declension?
From the house.
Correct. And Nick Hamati. Nick Hamati means.
Yeah.
You have the right meaning, but not the right declension.
Just for it to happen.
No
problem. Have left.
Leaves. leaves the parts.
Is that ni the same as, because you just said that ni and ni si dot di is down?
Yeah, ni,
is that
the,
down?
The prefix properly is ner, or sometimes nis, but it's usually ner. And that can mean down or out.
Hmm.
Maybe mana?
Yeah. So Nick Hamati literally means to walk out, but the applied meaning is leaves or departs or goes away. So what does this sentence mean?
So Vaidya Charya. The man leaves the city. The man leaves from his house.
Good. Man leaves from the house.
From the house. To go to the city.
To go to the city?
By chariot.
Great. Perfect.
Cool.
Yay. Okay. Well, that's enough to convince me that you guys have been picking up the material. Are there any questions or particular issues to be brought up? Any difficult sentences or grammatical cases that need clarification? There's several different ways of breaking down the word nirvana. The one that I'm actually most fond of is using nir. Nir can also mean not or without. And one possible meaning of vana is craving or wanting. So then nirvana can mean without craving. Nirvana. I mean, without craving.
Yeah.
And then the Pali form is simply nirvana. So this is another one of those fun vowel assimilation, consonant assimilations we'll come to later.
Where RV becomes DV?
Yes!
Similar things happen in Italian, though. Like, a lot of, like, the Latin, like, mm. with CT and a bunch of different things, they become TT.
That makes sense.
Mm.
Because
yeah.
it's like the herb, it's like your lips are closing anyway, you might as well just say a beat.
Exactly.
Yeah.
yeah.
And I find this happening just in speech, because I use the two words interchangeably, and I'll find myself sometimes say like, nirvana. because it's just natural.
Yeah.
Exactly, your lips are already moving in that direction. Okay, anything else? We could also look at some more sentences, if people want to look at some more sentences.
10-1 made me happy.
It made you happy?
Yeah.
Let's have a look at it. So, Kumara vanamhi mittehi saha ki litva bhattang bunjitong gehang dhavanti.
It's cute.
Oh, that is cute.
Isn't it just like all heartwarming?
Yeah, it kind of is. It makes you feel like a little kid again.
So I just thought maybe you're
like... Okay, great.
Does it mean the boy worshipped his friend Adam Clay?
There's no worshipping.
You've got parts of it correct. So let's go ahead and break this down. So what's Kumara?
The boys.
Boys, great. Vanamhi.
Oh, that's
so vana, like J Tavana. Great. Yeah, in the grove. In the grove or in the forest. Mittehi.
That's friend.
Friend, and what's the declension?
That's Instrumental.
Instrumental what? Singular or plural?
It's plural.
Great, yeah. So with friends. And saha. With, yeah. Kilitva. What's that? Great. Great. Yeah, you're doing wonderful so far. So what? Keep going. Batang bunjitung. Batang rice or food. Bunjitung. Yeah, bunjati can mean enjoy or it can just mean eat. So what's the declension here though? Bunjitung.
Might be throwing them off because of the weird.
Yeah, there's that.
Yeah.
Infinitive, yep. Yeah. So to eat, great. And gehung?
Gehung's house.
House. And what's the declension?
Homes.
Singular or plural?
It's plural.
I don't think so. Yep. And what's the declension? What's the case?
It's neuter or singular.
It could be neuter singular, yeah. So what is it? Is it nominative, accusative? What is it? Okay, probably accusative. Let's say to house. And dhavanti?
Runs.
Excellent.
Well, not runs.
Having
no, they run.
Yeah. Okay. So putting this all together, what is being said here?
So
having played with their food, the boys eat, wait, eat in the grove with their friends? No.
Okay. So the boys, they run to the house, having played with.
Good, keep going. So having played with their friends where?
In the grove.
Yeah, so having played with their friends in the grove, the boys... Great.
So
excellent.
If you wanted to, having played with their food though,
you'd be... it actually could be possible, but then we would expect
right.
to see...
Batena. Right. Excellent.
Yeah, we don't see that.
It's unfortunate.
Well, when you're writing your own Pali textbook, you can
I'm
have the boys playing with their food.
Immediately.
Okay. Anything else we want to look at? So upasaka samananang dhanang dhiranti silani rakhanti. Okay, so let's take it one word at a time and we'll sort things out. Upasaka, somebody other than Michael?
Lay devotees.
Okay. Samananang?
Two foreign monks. The object, accusative.
No, you were closer the first time.
Two or four of the...
Not two. What other word?
Four? Wait.
Or of?
Yes.
Belonging to?
Of four contemplatives. danang, dadanti. Dana.
Give.
Dadanti.
Gives.
Gives.
Give. They give.
They give, yep, plural. Silani.
Virtue.
Declension.
Plural.
Yes, plural. So virtues.
Yeah.
Yep.
Rakanti.
Protect. Yes. Excellent. So, putting it all together, what do we have?
The devotees who give dana to the contemplatives protect.
And they protect virtues.
They protect their virtues.
Yeah.
I see. So there's no causal relationship implied between the two clauses?
No.
Is there possessive in Pali or no?
What do you mean?
Like his, her.
Yeah, his, her.
Well, that's the genitive. Genitive is possessive.
Okay.
So if you wanted to say like
yeah.
specifically his, then yeah,
yeah.
that's tassa.
Tassa. Like
so
tassa.
The.
Okay.
Yeah. So ta is the pronoun.
Okay.
And then it's just using the genitive suffix.
Okay, so that's a possessive pronoun.
Yeah, so if you wanted to say his virtue, you would say tassa si lang, actually. His virtue.
But his virtues would be tassa.
Yeah, his virtues would be tassa si lani.
Okay. Awesome.
So the virtues of him.
Nice.
His virtues. You could interpret it that way, but I think it's unlikely. More likely, the point here is that they're protecting their own virtue.
So the devotees are protecting their own virtue, and the contemplatives are also protecting their own virtue?
No, the contemplatives are just being given dana.
Anything with
their
virtue.
Because they're object. Well, we hope the
contemplatives.
We hope. Freeloaders. No, we hope the contemplatives. There might be all kinds of things going on in the background, but we don't know.
Okay.
Hopefully, good things. Yeah, this is getting into the commentaries.
Okay.
Right, it takes like a single sentence and writes like a 10-page story about it.
So, is it implied because the devotees are the
subject.
Yeah.
Doing.
Yeah, so like earlier I had spoken about a single accusative being the target of multiple verbs. In this case, we have a single subject being the subject of multiple verbs.
And this seems like it would come from almost like a line of a poetry.
It might, yeah. Yeah, poetry, Pali poetry often has very strange grammar.
Yeah.
Which is why we won't be talking about it anytime soon.
Any poetry really does, right? Because you're stretching the language, the economy of language changes completely.
Yeah. Okay, any other sentences we want to look at? You're all done for today? All right. Well, I am impressed. You're definitely learning stuff. Well done. Do we want to add one more chapter or two more chapters for next week? Let's see what we're looking at. We can go ahead and turn this off now.